Hey folks, it's Dr. Sam. Good morning. And I want to address a question on double vision. This is a condition where the two eyes are not matching up and they're not aiming at the same place at the same time. And this creates two scenarios. Either you see double, or the brain says, I'm just going to suppress or shut off one of the eyes to avoid double. In either case, it's really challenging to navigate the world. And I want to give you some ideas on how to repair this situation. So some of the choices out there are surgery, where they change the length of the eye muscle. And also another option is doing Botox injections. So both of those, in my opinion, are only treating a symptom, and they're not going to work very well. In fact, in strabismus surgery, this is surgery when you see double, the success rate is somewhere between 30 and 80%, and usually the doctor has to go back in and do multiple surgeries. Because when you do eye muscle surgery, you're not telling the brain what you've done, so it actually creates more confusion in a person, because now the brain is trying to direct the eye muscles, but the eye muscle has changed its length, so it doesn't work very well. The brain is going to override the surgery. So I don't recommend surgery. I don't recommend Botox. What I recommend is a re-education process called vision therapy. This is a physical therapy for your eyes and brain to retrain how your eyes aim together. And we know that the eyes originate from brain tissue, so that the eyes qualify for something called neuroplasticity. They have a regenerative capability because they are a direct descendant of the brain. And I remember many years ago when I was working in some of the hospitals, people who had traumatic brain injury and they suffered double vision. I was very successful at getting them to reduce the double vision by doing some of these physical therapy eye exercises. And another thing that worked really well was something called therapeutic prism prescriptions. Now, this is very different than a prism prescription you get from an eye doctor that's trying to fix or force your eye to be in one position. That's a symptom approach. It doesn't work. But in terms of the therapeutic prisms that I use, they can actually shift your spatial awareness from left to right or up and down or expand your peripheral vision. And they're very effective at helping a person figure out, if I use more peripheral vision, I can actually begin to reduce my doubling. And in terms of reducing the double vision, as you continue to work on getting rid of the double vision, eventually the dominant pattern is going to be binocularity, which means that the two eyes work together. Now, some of the causes of double vision could be things like trauma, so traumatic brain injury, if you've been in a car accident. Stress is another reason why you can develop double vision. Obviously, neurological conditions, so you want to get that checked out. Make sure you're not suffering conditions like MS or Parkinson's. These neurodegenerative conditions can cause a weakness in the eye-brain connection. Some other reasons why you might get double vision could be things like keratoconus. These are corneal dystrophies, uncorrected astigmatism, cataract surgery, LASIK surgery, dry eye syndrome. So there are many reasons why you can develop double vision. And the way you want to think about it is that you want to use the brain-eye connection, because it's the brain that directs the eye muscles to aim together. So if you try to fix it from the eyeball perspective, it won't work very well. I would also say nutrients are really important. So magnesium, chromium, selenium as trace minerals, bilberry, lutein, zeaxanthin, quercetin, taurine, omega-3 fish oil, beta-carotene, another trace mineral, zinc. So you want to make sure you're getting enough eye nutrients for the brain and the eyes to kind of work together. So double vision is a condition that you can definitely reduce at any age. I recommend vision therapy, which is a form of physical therapy for your eyes and brain, and I do not recommend surgery or Botox injections. So that's my message for today. I want to thank you so much for tuning in. And until next time, take good care.